So let's ask ourselves this question. When control transfers to the shell code, what privileges are going to be used when this code is executed? We know the code is attacker code. The attacker actually created the code, placed it in memory, transferred control of this program that we were running before to the shell code. And remember, the program is running on behalf of some user. So it's a service. It may be running on behalf of root, or depending on what sort of privileges or credentials we have, some role or whatever it is. It could be a system process, for example. So the program is running with certain privileges. This program is now going and executing these instructions that make up the shell code. So whose privileges are we going to be using when the shell code or the instructions that make up the shell code get executed? These privileges are going to be the privileges that the host program, the program that gets exploited, was running with certain privileges. This attacker code now has the same privileges that the host program or the target program that got exploited had. So if this happened to be a system service, as I said, it's running with root privileges. Essentially, you have keys to the kingdom. You can access arbitrary resources. So the attacker used a vulnerable program, used the buffer overflow idea that we talked about, transferred control to its own code, that was the shell code, and the shell code lets it launch a command shell, and the command shell now can start whatever program it wants to, and that program would run on behalf of the host program's owner or group privileges, whatever that it had. So the attacker has come in and become you, either the system or a particular user who was running this vulnerable program. So this is how the attacker is able to execute arbitrary code with a legitimate user's credentials or privileges. Legitimate user's privileges are available to this arbitrary code that is being executed on behalf of the attacker. That's the best case scenario from the attacker's point of view. It is the worst case scenario from our point of view because somebody is executing code we have no knowledge of with our privileges. And they were able to get in to the system because there was a vulnerability that got successfully exploited. And as a result, the attacker has ability to do everything that he or she wants to do.